This is Sway. Sway.
Sway.
Sway.
In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
Shake your body.
Wake your fuck ass up. That's a
yo.
Man, I get excited. I down there and get erect when I hear that trailer.
Oh, boy.
I swear, man, I'm one of the originals. I was around when the first Star Wars movie came out. I was there. I've been using the Force. Since back then, I don't remember what year that was, but I was a kid. And you fast forward, and that's when we, when Luke was the hero, you know. And now we fast forward to 2015. We got a black man that's going to save the future, ladies and gentlemen. And he's here with us right now. John Boyega is here, ladies and gentlemen.
We got a black man that's going to save the future.
There it is, man. He's going to rescue us. He's going to deliver us. And he's here with us today on Sway in the Morning.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen to that. Amen to that.
John, welcome to the show.
I'm very, very happy to be here, man. I've been watching your videos for a long, long time, so it's good to be sitting here.
That's yes. What's up? What's been your favorite interview?
The Kanye.
You ain't got the answer, Sway. You ain't got... Sway.
You ain't got the answer, Sway.
Point.
That's not what I'm asking you.
I know. I just want you to give me a reason to say that.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Sway.
There it is right there, right? Man. That's a famous... Wow, you watched that in the UK?
Yeah, definitely. I binge on all of you guys.
On all our shows.
Yeah,
out
man,
here.
I love it.
Man, congratulations, though, you're doing. You're playing the role of Finn.
Yes.
And who is Finn?
Well, Finn is a stormtrooper who is under the order of Kylo Ren, and he decides that he doesn't want to be part of the army no more.
Yeah.
So he escapes. And when he does, he crosses paths with Rey, who's played by Daisy Ridley, and the little spear ball droid, who's BB-8. Uh-huh. And he has heat on him.
Yeah.
And he brings that to their two innocent lives, and they all are kind of put together, and they all have to go on this incredible journey. And then they meet the old generation, Han Solo.
Wow.
And they all kind of team together and try to bring balance to the Force and all that mystical stuff.
So Han Solo is being played by?
Harrison Ford. I don't know if you've heard of him.
Yeah.
He's familiar to me.
Indeed.
Semi-famous.
But isn't it great that Harrison Ford is still... Like, he's still active. He looks great.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know what I mean? He still has that mystique about him.
Yeah.
He still has that old Hollywood, you know,
glamour.
Flair, that's glamour about him, right?
Yeah.
Were you the least bit intimidated? Were you familiar with the old Star Wars movies?
Absolutely. I've been a fan for a long time. I was born in 92.
Okay.
So for me, I was exposed to
You
the
said
Phantom
that like
Menace.
You're old or something.
No,
that was cute.
No. I actually was saying that. I'm young. I was born in 1992.
23, right?
Soak that in.
Okay.
The millennials,
Yeah, soak it in.
Cocky-ass millennials, but, I tell you. I don't care, man.
But in 92, I wasn't trying to go back to 77 and watch, you know, those visual effects. So we got the prequels. Then I loved the energy. I didn't understand the story. I was so young. And then I went back to the originals when I knew about character and fun. And then I was just a big fan from then.
That's all about resistance, right?
Yeah.
Right? We experience that today.
Yeah,
we're
for
seeing
sure.
that all shapes and forms,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
It's the same story over and over. Black people in this country. No, just gotta...
Come on now.
You know, so how did you grow up, man? Tell me about your life, man.
Yeah.
Where did you grow up?
I grew up in London. I'm born and raised. Both my mom and dad are Nigerian. Decided to come to London, start a new life. They had a couple kids. Their claim to fame was this one, the last one.
Okay.
And basically, you see the way I dropped that there. I just let it settle.
Oh, Johnny boy, go ahead.
And then after that, I was raised in Peckham, southeast London.
Mm-hmm.
And that's like the suburban area of London.
Mm-hmm.
And I was raised in a very cool community of people, mostly minorities.
Mm-hmm.
And then I went to theatre school, and my theatre was like 2 minutes away from me, and so I was going to theatre. Obviously, my dad's a minister, so going to church and then going to school. And I just did that for a few years until I decided to take my career seriously.
Yeah. Your dad was a minister?
He still is. He still is
a minister?
He still is, yes.
Yes. So did you have to hide things from him, like if you were having sex or smoking weed or stuff like that?
You see, those things I don't indulge in.
Okay.
I'm a Disney guy, all right? Finn is a virgin, people. He is.
Finn is a virgin, okay.
Mind you used to see the way he looks at Rey. He's disgusting. But hey.
Yeah.
Hey. No, I've... I've always been cool and open with my dad, and so that's something that's important. He's a minister, but he's not like, you know, clouded and stupid minister. He's lived in Nigeria and had his days.
Nigerian folks are very proud people.
Absolutely,
right? With an incredible history.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Did you ever, like, you don't have the, usually when people come up here, they tell a story of strife and struggle, and you know, I was in the streets and I shot a few dudes, they shot me. I live to tell the story, and now I got a rap career. You don't have that story?
I don't have that. I've never shot anyone. Okay. You know, I stayed away from all of that. I decided to take my life seriously.
Smart man.
I'm 23. I'm trying to be rich.
Right.
I can't do that when I'm dead.
American dream. Yeah. So what's been your lowest moment?
I think it's a lot of it has been the reality that your circumstance does not in any form match to what you want to be.
Yeah.
My reality just did not represent me being in a Star Wars movie or even being an actor, because it was just basic.
Yeah.
And when in basic, it's not a bad thing. It's a cool opportunity that we all get. We get free education.
Mm-hmm.
We get, you know, at least decent home, even if it's government housing, whatever. Mm-hmm. You have a roof.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, it was, my circumstance did not reflect and did not give me any clues as to what my future would be. So to have to make that decision and feel like, I mean, you understand, you change your life and make a decision that is uncanny.
Mm-hmm.
It was a big low point, but after getting into it and just doing it, it turned out to be something of value.
Because what's bomb about that is, I was just talking to a friend of mine and we were discussing how life is 10% circumstance and then 90% your attitude towards that circumstance.
And it takes a lot of time to, it takes some people short amounts of time and some people a longer time to kind of get to grips that, you know what, no one's gonna scout me. Mm-hmm. Life isn't just gonna pay me $1 million. I'm gonna have to probably work my ass off just to survive and you know, honor my Nigerian family name.
Yeah,
and I think that I have.
You have. You're doing them proud. John Boyega is here. Am I saying that correctly?
Yes, you are. You are.
I practiced that before you came over here. You caused quite a stir in the United States. I don't know how they reacted in the UK, because you, for the most ignorant reason of them all, you're just an actor first, you know, and regardless of your skin complexion, really, we want to make sure you play the role correctly. But there were a lot of people, racist, who, you know, the movie got a lot of backlash because you were the star of the movie. And what the fuck? We got a black guy in there? Like, did you hear it? Did they react like that in the UK at all?
It wasn't for me. To be honest, it was identified as a stateside thing.
Okay.
But to be honest, it could be a worldwide thing.
Yeah.
But for me, honestly, what has Star Wars done? More than 50 million in pre-sale tickets. Where the race is at, man? Because those guys booked their tickets for the movie.
Yeah.
Regardless,
right?
Regardless.
Yeah.
And that's something that I like to fixate on.
Yeah.
Is the true Star Wars fans who are just ready to see a good movie despite, you know, my gorgeous chocolate skin.
Yeah, exactly.
Gorgeous.
Yes. I'm saying yes. Like,
see how that gets you? You see how that gets you, Sway? Sway, reload, man. Reload, Sway.
It's self-love,
man. Started going to the dark side.
Okay, we're going to open up the phone line. 888-742-3345. Give us a call.
Let's get down there, cuz. Let's go fuck them up.
Hey, I'm killing them. I'm killing them straight. Let's get two lot blood.
Come.
Yo, that was from Attack the Block, which is John Boyega is in that movie. And I remember watching that movie and was just bugged the fuck out. Like, what am I watching right now? What is, who made this? Like, is this a movement that I'm not familiar with?
Right.
But it was very familiar to me, you know, because it took place in, I guess, an urban area.
Absolutely.
And aliens came down and
invaded
the hood.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And the hood fought back.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
Was that movie, because I think I might have caught it later on. Mm. Was that movie like a big phenomenon over in the UK initially?
No, we've had a long line of urban films which kind of like concentrate on the circumstances of those areas. But that was the first movie that kind of had an appeal over here in the States, you know, with the old school styled alien invasion movie kind of mirroring like the Warriors, the original Warriors.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
And so it was something that had leverage here. Mm-hmm. But in the UK, it was like one of the many movies. Yeah. It's like, you know, I don't respect Barbershop anymore. It's just many of the chains. It's, it's just part of the franchise.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, out in the UK, it's just a normal film. But here, you guys just showed it so much love.
We showed it a lot of love.
Crazy.
If it wasn't for us, you might not have gotten the role in Star Wars.
I agree.
Yeah,
I agree. Mm-hmm. I had to come to the States. I had to come to you guys.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, thank you, man. I appreciate you kissing up.
You ain't getting a check, Sway.
Okay. He
felt it.
Hey, John, do you rap at all?
Absolutely not.
You look disgusting when I said
that. No. I listen.
Who's the hot dudes in the UK right now that you like?
I like Giggs personally. He's from my hometown, from Peckham, and he's got a deep voice. He's got an easy flow. He's sick. Have you heard of him?
I haven't heard of Giggs.
You guys should research that dude. And he's about real stuff. I love
the way. Yo, pull him up. Let's see what he got. He got a song.
And he's a big Star Wars fan, which is always.
And it's a big star. That works, right?
Yeah, that works for me.
So Star Wars, everything changes now, right? Because in the music business, they sign you for 5 albums or whatever, 3 to 5 albums. Do they do that with this?
I'm in limbo right now. I think the fixation is so much because Star Wars has been away for so long. So there's so much concentration on releasing this movie. And this movie is the be all and end all of everything.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's going to do very well. Obviously, the money situation, they know their call. But in terms of, you know, critical success and people enjoying it, I think it's going to be a great ride.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, John, how you doing? I'm DB. I just had a question because we have a lot of aspiring actors and even struggling actors who listen to the show. And everybody wants that one moment where they're like, yes, I'm in a fucking big movie or I got a big opportunity.
Yeah.
When JJ called you and said, you're going to be the star of the new Star Wars movie. Yeah. What was the first thing that came through your head? Were you shitting bricks? Were you like, hell yeah, groupies? Like, I mean.
Oh, man. I mean, I was relieved. If you've worked for so long, I mean, people normally, when they talk about me, they go from Attack the Block to Star Wars. There's a few years in between where there has been a lot of no's, a lot of you're not right enough. And it's a lot to take in. So to be rewarded for the failures and the hard work and the persistence, when JJ told me face to face, I was just like, okay, now I can really go home. Like I can really, you know, go to my parents and be like, okay,
exhale.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I don't need to get a job.
You don't have to pay this month's rent.
I have to pay this month's rent.
It's cool that he said that because I don't mean to cut you off. Because Harrison Ford, when he got the role of Han Solo, he was working as a carpenter. Because his career was kind of fledgling and he was almost like, you know, I'm probably not even going to do much after this.
Yeah.
And he was reading in place of other actors for the people who are auditioning for the role of Han Solo.
Yeah.
He ended up getting the role.
Yeah.
Wow. Greg is on the line from L.A. John Boyega is here. He plays Finn in a new movie, Star Wars, the Star Wars movie, coming out December
18th.
So 18th. It's the 18th.
Yep. Los Angeles, it'll be in the 14th.
Okay, we got Greg on the line. Greg, what up?
Hey, Greg.
Hey, what up, Sway? How you doing?
I'm great, man. How about you?
I can't complain, man. Headed to school right now. Headed to my acting class. I go to Cal State Northridge and the Northridge area of Los Angeles.
You made that louder?
No.
I'm sorry?
You need that louder?
Yeah.
Okay, there you go. Okay.
Oh, okay. Am I talking too loud? I'm sorry.
No. What is your question, Greg? We only got a few seconds.
All right, my question to you, John, is this, man. Congratulations on what you're doing, man.
Thank you, sir.
I'm still speaking you to existence. I'm going to have you next year, I guarantee you.
All right.
Got to speak it to existence. John, with that being said, are you planning on working with Idris Elba, or has he given you any advice?
I know Idris, and obviously he's someone that has pioneered the movement of the Black British folk that have come to America. I'm really looking. I want to collaborate with him for sure, and I think that something will definitely come up. But it has to be the right thing.
Okay, he's Finn, so he has options now. Okay, we got Sam from Colorado on the line. Sam, what up?
Hey, Sam.
Hey, good morning. How you doing?
Hey, Sam.
Oh, good. Hey, I just wanted to know, how does it feel to be a part of something that makes such a huge impact over so many generations?
I have to say, it hasn't hit me yet. I feel like I'm on autopilot to a certain extent. The movie's not out. I can still walk the streets, you know, with a scarf around my head. But it hasn't hit me yet. But when it does, I'm sure it's going to be insane, man. It's going to be crazy.
Oh, it's going to it's gonna hit you like a freight train.
I know.
But yeah, with Jennifer Lawrence, you, all you guys, big lineup, young actors who get rich, and you know, and we don't see you no more. You come back to the show?
I'll definitely come back to
that's
the show.
Promise?
That's a good promise.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Well, before you go, we got one more thing to do. Since you're new to the show, man, we got this thing called the mystery sack.
Go ahead and reach in.
Dig deep. Dig deep.
Put your hands into Sway's sack.
That sounds gross.
It's Sway's Mystery Sack on Shade 45.
All right. John Boyega is here. It's his first time sticking his hand in my sack.
Oh, yeah.
Lord right. have mercy.
Star Wars, The Force Awakens.
Mm-hmm.
To tell them the rules right here, Tracy.
All right, Virgin, listen up. So, you got to pick three questions, okay. One at a time, read it aloud, and yeah. Answer each one honestly.
Okay, cool.
Good luck, John.
Okay. All right. If you could be in a movie with any three actors, alive or dead, who would you pick? I would pick Denzel Washington. Mm. I'd pick Robert Downey Jr. Mm. And Angela Bassett.
Angela Ooh,
he
Bassett.
Had that down.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Robert Downey Jr.
Yeah, who is also my mentor at the moment. So
yeah, the only white person in that list. Okay.
He's a great guy.
He is.
Okay, cool. Describe the first time you ever got your ass whooped. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I was walking home from primary school at the time, and this dude saw me talking to his girl.
Yeah.
And he decided to just slap me in the face.
Oh.
He slapped me in the face. It was square on, and I can't lie, I didn't recover from that. It was the first time. It was the first time. I didn't know what my buddy did. It just froze. The floor was my friend.
Wow.
I played dead, man. I played dead. That's
you
how you keep alive.
Dead.
Yeah. I keep my face pretty, people. That's how you stay alive, guys.
So he played
you
dead.
Played dead. Played dead.
You guys slap more than you punch?
Oh, no. He slapped me. I don't know whether that was a childhood choice.
Okay.
All right. Last question. All right. Oh, good. Yes, Lord. Fuck, marry, kill. Rihanna, Miley Cyrus, Taylor Swift.
Which one would you fuck? Which one would you marry? Which one would you get rid of?
I would definitely make love to Rihanna.
Okay.
I think she wants to be fucked.
The thing fuck, I don't know. Yeah, I mean, that's a combination though, isn't it?
Yeah. Aggressive lovemaking. Hey, do that.
Let's okay. do I'm prestige. Let's do that.
Okay.
Marry. Oh, no.
A Taylor or a Miley?
Oh, gosh. Marry Taylor.
Okay.
Taylor's
good. Taylor's a sweet woman.
Sorry,
Kill?
Miley.
Well, there's only one left.
Make
All right.
Your
house.
Good
All
Lord.
Right. John Boyega, man.
Thank you.
Yo, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Continue
man.
Success.
Thank All right. You,
and I'll
you,
see
man.
You when you come back.
All right.
Okay. And then Thank we're going to come back. We're going to talk with Buckshot from Duck Down. They're celebrating their 20-year anniversary. Sway in the morning, Shade 45.
It's Sway in the morning, only on Shade 45.